Hi again. I'm Hank Fanema, the CEO and Senior Engineer at Strategic Systems Engineering, and in this video, we'll discuss climate adaptation and specifically the power of LiDAR to analyze flood risk exposure. The increased heat from climate change causes desiccated soil, dried out soil that doesn't absorb water. It also causes occasionally very heavy rainfall. This results in more water not infiltrating and instead traveling overland and overwhelming watersheds and stream beds and towns. As mentioned in an earlier video, the IDFCC tool allows us to estimate the elevated risk of extreme rainfall events, extreme precipitation. The IDFCC tool is useful for comparing a variety of weather impacts in the context of climate change. We can estimate how many millimeters of rain will fall in a 24-hour period, comparing a 1 in 20-year event, a 1 in 50-year event, and a 1 in 100-year event with two different standard climate change scenarios called RCP 4.5 and RCP 8.5. And we compare these scenarios to the historic 1 in 20-year event, 1 in 50-year event, and 1 in 100-year event. The RCP 4.5 and 8.5 scenarios illustrate the effect of higher loading of greenhouse gases to the atmosphere. But you may be asking, so what? Am I a greater financial risk? Let's find out using the LiDAR data. Public Safety Canada provides standard damage functions for building assets at risk. Using these functions and the LiDAR data, we can measure the levels of flooding that will cause different levels of damages to these assets. LiDAR lets us measure very accurately the ground level elevation of buildings, houses, stores, shopping malls, factories. As a flood rises, these different buildings are damaged to different levels. Over an entire watershed, the LiDAR also tells us exactly the lay of the land. This is important because these elevations play a role in how water will travel over the landscape. Using the LiDAR data, we can estimate how water will accumulate in depressions and stream beds and their flooding impact on towns and crops. We do this for clients using LiDAR, geographic information systems, and flood risk modeling software. We use WDPM, Telemac, and high-performance cloud computing to harness the full power of the high-quality, high-resolution LiDAR data available within Manitoba. These modeling tools are state-of-the-art and can help us predict how floods will occur before they do and estimate their financial impact. In the next video, we'll explore climate adaptation that builds resilience to flooding and drought. Thanks for watching.